Paolo from Philadelphia asked me, what do you mean with practicing what we need instead of what we like? Well, this I say because sometimes people, when are thinking they practice, they actually are just playing stuff and wandering from one thing to the other that they like, but it's not upgrading their level. So therefore, to know what you need a teacher, because you yourself maybe cannot find out what you need. For instance, how good you are in rhythm, how good you are in the scales, how good you are with the rasgueos, with different techniques, and to the application of theory and the application of technique in pieces, playing, learning chords, new chords and playing chords, etc. All these things, you need a teacher to have the objective view of that. That's what we do in Skype, exactly, because I'm coaching there and I can see which are your weak spots, and then we improve those areas, and then that is what you need. Maybe when you practice, your mind will say, oh my God, I don't want to play with metronome rhythm, or I don't think this is much fun, and then one, two, I have to count the stuff or play, and the mind is reluctant to follow. So then people generally just quit that and play what they songs they like of stuff, and that is not helping you to improve your playing. So therefore, some stuff which are this gray area, so to say, the teacher should be very smart and able to find this. If you are alone, it's just like doing your own dental work. How you will do your own dental work? You need a dentist. So therefore, if you have a teacher, most of these problems comes when we don't have don't follow a method or don't have a teacher. If you follow a method, then teachers should be able to find out which are your weaknesses and improve what you have not so good and make even better what you are good at. And then therefore, your practice is focused in areas of what you need. And then if you do that, you will be able to play anything what you like, and you will see actually that you like your practice, even when it's stuff that you are not good at, because it's much fun to learn and see your own progress day by day.
Me ayudó porque descubrí ahí la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías están en cada momento, ¿no?
Muy bien, Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.